How's it going, everyone? It's Tel Aviv from Weather Swarm Drop. That was today. It's November 16, 2021, and today we're going to focus on the potentially major nor'easter that could impact the Northeast later next week, and we'll talk about if you could experience snow and heavy snow at that throughout the Northeast for next week, as we have the possibility of strong winds, coastal flooding, and also heavy rain and heavy snow associated with this nor'easter next week. But before I begin, make sure to subscribe if you want to see more weather-related content. Make sure to like if you like this video, and make sure to turn on post notifications if you want to see even more weather-related content. So let's begin by taking a look at the European model right around the 5-day mark, and you see not much is going on. If we were to take a look at what's happening right now throughout the United States, we do have this trough that's moving just north of the Canada and United States border. However, for the most part, it should stay just north of the United States, so you shouldn't see much in the much precipitation in the form of snowfall, besides maybe the extreme northern portion of Minnesota and the extreme northern portions of Maine. But outside of that, for the most part, it's going to be a rain event for most of the United States. But the key thing here is that behind this trough, we're going to see a major jet stream dip, and this jet stream dip will lead to our next potential nor'easter just off the northeast coast. So if we were to continue to move forward with what the European model is forecasting when it comes to the next nor'easter, you see that a trough should come off the Pacific Northwest coast and Alberta Clipper, and it should move further southwestward and bring that cold air further southeastward, further southeastward as well, where we're going to see a pretty strong pressure gradient between this ridge that's located towards the Rocky Mountain Range and this low pressure system, which is expected to move further southward and bring a strong northwesterly flow to cool down a lot of the temperatures throughout the northern United States. And as it does so, we will begin to see this low pressure system rapidly intensify as it heads further eastward once it encounters a little bit more instability as a result of this strong northwesterly flow interacting with this very warm air that's located right around the Gulf Stream of the Atlantic Ocean, right around pretty much hugging the Atlantic coast at this time. And we're going to see a very low pressure that's very reminiscent of how mid-latitude cyclone looks, where we do see rain, where we do see a large area of precipitation extending along this cold front, and very stable and cool air on the back side of this storm, and snow on the northwestern portion where the air temperature will be cold enough to support snowfall. And as you can see, it does bring, this low pressure system does bring a decent amount of snow throughout the Great Lakes, especially where we could see lake effect snow associated with this low pressure system. However, it becomes really interesting as it heads even further eastward, because you see that right around the 7-day mark, we begin to see a negative tilt with the jet stream. And if you don't know what a negative tilt is, it's pretty much when the jet stream pretty much moves straight northward or southward, where whichever direction you want to call it. You see that as the jet stream takes a vertical, moves at a vertical direction, it sort of tilts, and that's what a negative tilt is, when we see the warm air filter in above the cool air, and that creates a very unstable environment. And that is the cause, one of the leading causes of just major snowstorms and major low pressure system just off the northeast coast, where when we see a negative tilt, that means there's a lot of instability for a low pressure system to rapidly intensify and a lot of convection to occur. And when this happens, you should expect major impacts when it comes to wind, when it comes to rainfall, when it comes to snowfall, whichever the case may be. You should experience major impacts when you see a negative tilt like this. And this scenario would be no different if this were to come to fruition, because you see that by right around the 7-day mark, the negative tilt becomes extremely pronounced. As you see, this the low pressure drops to a millibar pressure 975 right around the 7-day mark, and we see a very powerful negative tilt, where we're seeing the jet stream literally go the opposite direction, move the opposite direction, and that creates just an extremely unstable environment throughout the Northeast. And this would be a major storm for you guys. Even if you weren't to experience heavy snowfall, you should experience strong winds out of this. Heavy rainfall is certainly a concern, and obviously coastal flooding as a result of these strong winds. And if we were to continue to move forward, the thing that's also very concerning about a negative tilt with the jet stream is that it typically means that the low pressure system would move a lot more slowly, because of course the jet stream winds pretty much move the opposite direction. So instead of this low pressure system moving directly from a westerly to easterly direction, it sort of meanders as a result of this negative tilt, where the negative tilt steers the low pressure system further back westward, and that makes the low pressure system meander over the same area for a long duration, which would maximize the impacts for a lot of you guys in the Northeast. And that would definitely be a major concern if this low pressure system were to do that. And that's what the European is currently forecasting. Now, there's still a lot of uncertainty with this, because of course I'm going beyond the 7-day mark, so a lot could change. But when we look at the GFS model as well, it's also forecasting a negative tilt. So, and both the computer model has been persisting on this idea for quite some time now, which is giving a little bit more confidence that we will see a major jet stream dip by early next week that might induce a negative tilt in the jet stream for a powerful storm to occur in the Northeast. However, the location of where exactly a low pressure system will be is different between the GFS and the European model, because the GFS model is forecasting the low pressure system to develop more rapidly, well further northward, north of the United States and Canada border, while the European model wants to pretty much meander the low pressure system further southward, where the Northeast United States would experience more impacts than if the GFS model were correct, where the low pressure system mainly stays just north of the United States and Canada border. So there's still a lot of uncertainty regarding the exact track of this, and we still need to determine if a jet stream dip of this magnitude will lead to a negative tilt for a major storm to occur in the Northeast and a major snowstorm. So if we were to take a look at the GFS model, you see that this first low pressure system will bring a strong northwesterly flow for a major jet stream dip to occur. However, the first low pressure system is well north of the United States border, so most of the snow is just the north, you guys. However, the thing is that since the low pressure system is causing such a major jet stream dip, it's gonna interact with the warm air that's located right over the jet stream for a lot of lift in the atmosphere to occur right around the Gulf Stream for another new low pressure system to form just off the East Coast. And that would be our main primary concern when it comes to this storm, the second low pressure system that forms along this cold front. And the location really all depends on how far south this jet stream dips, because if this jet stream dip were to dip further southward, then we're more likely to see the low pressure system form further southward, and we're more likely to see the low pressure system have more of an influence when it comes to the wind direction for the warm air to filter in on north side and the cold air to filter in on the south side. And that will create a negative tilt that would steer this storm closer to the northeast rather than further northward into Canada, like the GFS model was saying. So we need to really see how far south this jet stream will dip to determine where exactly a low pressure system will form and how much impacts you should expect in the Northeast. You see, of course, the GFS model is mainly forecasting this low pressure system, say, north of the United States Canada border, but still bringing heavy snow and strong winds throughout the Northeast, but it isn't to the magnitude as what the European model is saying, where it's taking much larger snow amounts throughout the Northeast in general. So the jet stream dip will really play a big role in how much impacts you should expect throughout the Northeast. However, I will say that it is becoming increasingly likely we will see some sort of potentially major storm just off the Northeast or somewhere along the East Coast. The main questions remain where, how powerful, and how much snow you should expect, and how much cold air there will be for you guys in the Northeast to experience snowfall, as those questions are going to be very hard to answer when we're forecasting 7 days out. I'll make sure to keep you guys updated once we get more in-depth detail of where exactly the soil pressure system will form. But as of right now, it's very difficult to forecast. If you were to take a look at what the GFS model is forecast, actually, I showed you guys the forecast run before the 12Z run. This is an 18 run, so let me go back to the radar actually to show you guys where exactly you should expect the snow from the GFS model. And in the latest GFS model run, it's taking a little bit more of a powerful storm to the northeast and a little bit more snow for the northeast, which is definitely concerning. And the low pressure system does form a little bit earlier than what than the 12Z run, so it is definitely something you guys want to keep in mind. We're gonna pay close attention to this as we get further updates from the computer models, but it's uncertain, I'd say, for right now. If the GFS model were correct, this the amount of snowfall you should expect throughout the Northeast, and you see that most of the snow is pretty much exclusively for the interior Northeast. The most snowfall is right around the main area where of course, the negative tilt will be located and where that low pressure system will be located if the GFS model were correct. But outside of that, you see most of the interior Northeast is experiencing snow, while the Interstate 95 corridor is pretty much staying out of most of the snow. But we can't rule out the possibility you guys will experience snow from this because, again, we're forecasting this 7 days out, and there's still a lot of questions that remain regarding the track of this storm and how much cold air there will be. So even close to the coastal United States, you should pay close attention to this in case there is a snowstorm that impacts you guys. And also, even if it doesn't snow, there is a pretty good possibility you'll experience coastal flooding, strong winds out of the soil pressure system, even if you don't experience snow from this. So this is definitely something you need to keep in mind throughout the Northeast for this week. Pretty much the entire Northeast needs to pay close attention to this, as you see that right around the 7 day mark, where we are experiencing a large amount of snow throughout the interior Northeast. Same look at the European model. It's bringing a little bit more snow closer to the coastal cities, and it's impacting a larger area, of course, as a result of this negative tilt pretty much being centered right over the Northeast rather than in Eastern Canada. You see that the snow is extending closer to the coast. We're seeing heavier snow amounts right around the interior Northeast as well. So there's definitely something we need to pay close attention to over the next several days. Really all depends on how far south that jet stream dips to see where that negative tilt will be located for a major, potentially major snowstorm to occur in the Northeast. And as I'll keep you guys updated with that. Next, taking a look at the Arctic Oscillation forecast, you see we're expecting to dip down into the negative phase very, very soon, which would mean that we're more likely to experience major jet stream dips for a lot more cold air and a lot more unstable air to unstable air masses to pretty much occur in the United States for more snowstorms to occur. So this is something we need to keep in mind, that over the next week or two, we could experience more snowstorms as a result of a negative Arctic Oscillation coming through the United States. Now, taking a look at my forecasts, you see that pretty much in the areas in dark blue, that's where you have maybe a slightly stronger possibility of experiencing snowfall. There is a large possibility that most of these areas, there's still a pretty good possibility that a lot of these areas don't experience much snow, but there's also an equal possibility you could experience a major snowstorm out of this, depending on where the soil pressure system is located. And even if there isn't a major snowstorm, you still need to pay attention to damaging winds, coastal flooding, and potentially heavy rain and heavy or heavy snowfall for the Northeast. So make sure to keep that in mind for early next week, as this is something we're going to need to keep in mind over keep an eye on over the next several days, as we get more updates with the forecast. But yeah, guys, I guess that's it for this video. I thank guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you want to see more weather related content. Make sure to like if you like this video, and make sure to turn on post notifications if you want to see even more weather related content. And I hope you guys have a good day.